My poem is titled, They Whisper. It whispers in my ears at night, talking when I try to sleep. It sings loudest in the night when I'm alone. But the voice whispers during the day, you are not good enough. Why do you think that they will be different than the others? Why do you think that this time will be different? It follows me day and night. But if you see me in the hallway, I flash you down to smile, wink, count a joke or two, it used to make stupid to draw a smile from a sad face. At least, that is how people see me. That is not the real me. The real me sits alone in my dark, solar-themed room, shaking from memories, like a man, and gasping for breath like a man who is drowning in a sea of deep red, struggling as the blood pounds through my veins and heart throbbing so loud that I can't hear. I can't breathe, I can't hear, and my brain cries out for help. The real me sits in my bed at night with a short, sharp knife in one hand and a splendid pen in the other, trying to decide whether to write my pen on a notebook or on my skin. I cringe as I feel the smooth weight of the knife running across my pale skin, and tears run down my face as an inner pain finds an audible voice. An agonized cry escaping from the depths of my soul. Finally, finding the words. With blood running down my skin, I drop the knife, put my head in my hands, and fall. I weep until I can weep no more, and fall into an agonized sleep. The real me is a monster. The blackness of depression stains my soul, and words of feverishly rage through my mind, scarring and reopening old wounds that I would much rather leave alone. Once again, I sit with the knife in the pain, looking from one to the other. The voices in my head are overpowering. But then, a new voice appears. I love you, it says. You are worth it. The choice is easier this time. I still get your story, but this time I do not write it on my skin. Now, I write you. Sometimes the things I write as we've been hunched over, shaking and gasping for breath, with the blood pounding in my ears and the echoes of my past roaring in my brain, of voices that I thought would never come at me again. But I love them. I love you. Thank you.